JF Boxing TV reporting live and direct at Bethnal Green in London with the man that is Chad Sugden. Chad, I've got to say, what an amazing performance there, live on TV in front of Craig Richards. Got the draw, brilliant fight, amazing. What's your viewpoint?
Yeah, I believe I could have done more, but on a week's notice I don't think it's a bad fight against the number four in the UK. And a lot of people coming up to me saying the fight just edged it by a round. So coming here and getting a draw on a matchroom show at York Hall in his hometown, like, that means something, doesn't it? So it must have been a good close fight. And I'll take it and I will improve on it. And next time we get it on with a full camp, do you know what I mean? He's in trouble.
I mean, your dad did mention that you've not really had a proper training camp for this. You went into the fight with an injury as well. And he said that you were about 70% of your fighting capacity, so to go in there and get that result, phenomenal performance.
Yeah, but I'm a fighter, no excuses, great fight. Craig Richards put on a great fight tonight, and to be honest, he's better than what I thought he was, but we still know we've got the skills to beat him, and I come on stronger towards the end. On a week's notice, with hardly any sparring, all that was wrong in the first few rounds was getting caught with a jab too much, and that was probably nicking him the fight, a few clean shots in there, but then I started to take over, and there's a lot. It was a great fight, entertaining fight. So let's do it again. Like, if it sells the show, let's do it again. You give me 8 weeks' notice, I'll sell 300-400 tickets to York Hall again, and I'll be fit. I'm ready to go again.
We both know that when you fight in Nottingham, I mean, you've got literally like 75% of Newark going down there. Normally about 400-500 fans going down there. So the Newark Army is going to be there next time round.
Oh yeah, for sure, there was there tonight, do you know what I mean? There's a few there tonight, and that's on a week's notice, so when we get the proper notice, we'll do it again. But at the end of the day, yeah, I fought a lot heavy, I can make super middle, let's see where this journey takes me. Whatever journey matchroom you want me to go down, I can do either, and let's light up the super middle, let's light up the light heavy, and I hope Richards and Peters have a great British title fight, and I think it's going to be an interesting fight.
Would you say that a draw was a fair result? Because Craig was saying that he thought he edged it.
Yeah, but Craig ain't judging the fight. He's in there. Like, if you actually land clean scoring shots, I landed more clean scoring shots. Without that, the only thing is when I'm walking back to that corner with this nose and these eyes, I just look like I lost a round. But if you actually watch it back, mute the commentary and watch it back, even Jay Nelson had it a draw. Like, when them boys at Sky Sports are having a draw, they know what the crack is, do you know what I mean? Like, it's a draw. End of it. Look, I believe I could have done more, and I'm not happy with a draw. Look, I'm not happy with my performance, but I believe a draw is a fair result.
You're not happy with your performance?
Not really, no, because, look, I'm too slick, and I look like I've been too slick tonight. I had to go in there and battle it out, do you know what I mean? And towards the end, I started showing my skills, and that's when I started bringing the real me out, but I'd love to do it again. Yeah, I love entertaining. Look, guys, are you not entertained? Like, that was the best fight of the night. No one said any different. Let's do it again.
To be honest with you, I mean, when you was in the ring, you was evading a lot of punches and you was showing your two slick skills. And the fact that you got hit with some big shots and you just kind of shrugged them off and then got straight back into it and landed some heavy shots yourself, you proved that you've got a chin as well. And to be a champion, you need that durability, and that's what you've shown tonight.
Me, I'm a fighter through and through. Like, look, everyone knows me, yeah, in the kickboxing world, I'm getting kneed in the face, elbows, the lot, and I'm coming through it with flying colours, winning at the end. Tonight, I got caught with a few shots, didn't faze me, do you know what I mean? And that's what he was worried about, and I could see him getting worried as the fight went on, and I see him going down his corner. I was first up at the start of every round, and that's like my little thing. I like to be first up at the start of the round, and he wasn't, and look, it's a close fight, and I didn't expect to get the win on a matchroom show tonight and at York Hall, but the way I've been treated by matchroom has been amazing. They're the best promotion I've worked with by far, do you know what I mean? It felt like home, so I'd love to come back again and fight super middle as well, or light heavy, whichever they want me to, and then if Craig Richards gets through the Peters fight, alright, then we'll fight him again.
think you'll be watching that Craig Richards, Shaq and Pitters fight on Channel 5 very closely, and potentially you might be in line to fight maybe the winner of that, or maybe even potentially Sam Jones's fight at Cody Davis.
Yeah, I mean, look, we'll fight anybody, do you know what I mean? But the thing is, I wanna fight again on Matchroom with a full camp, and I wanna fight on a big show again. Let's do it again. Just fought at your call on a week's notice, yeah, and fucking smashed it, do you know what I mean? There's no stopping me. Hit me with a bus and I'll keep coming. Do you know what I mean? Like, people think I'm just too slick, I'm too young, this and that. Are you having a laugh, mate? I've just gone in there with that boy and he's hit me with all he's got, and I've come back. Everyone said if it went another two rounds, he wouldn't have coped. Do you know what I mean? So don't give it the biggie about, oh, I thought I won. End of the day, a fight's a fight, and in a street, if you fight, it's the person who lasts the longest. Do you know what I mean? I was there going strong for the whole fight, and if people are coming up to me after, from round here, saying they thought I won, then I'll take that. But end of the day, I wasn't personally that happy with my performance, but I'll come back stronger. Do you know what I mean? And a draw's a draw. It's not a loss, but a draw's as good as a loss. Every boxer knows that. No one wants to see a draw. Fucking in K1 when I used to fight, you had to do an extra round if it was a draw. So, do you know what I mean? No one wants to see that. It's like, but it was a great fight. And everyone on social media, stuff like that, I got loads of messages, loads of friends saying, best fight of the night. Like, and that's just not just me, that's Craig Richards as well. So fair play to him, because I've stepped in a week notice, but it's a hard fight for him to take with a fight coming up next month.
I mean, what a way to cap off your 2019. I mean, everything that you said in previous interviews, when I've travelled to Suggy's gym, everything that you've said, that you've delivered. You said you was going to beat Luke Blackledge, you beat Luke Blackledge. You said you was going to run through Favour Decor, you beat him. And then you said you was going to fight Craig Richards even before the fight even happened, and you'd beat him, and you didn't beat him. It was a draw, but it was a very close fight. And towards the back end of the fight, you come on very, very strong. And what do you want in 2020? What's the first thing that you want to do in 2020?
Look, I want to get back in the gym, get my injuries all right, and then I want some more big fights for me. Look, I want to be on Matchroom again. So, super middle, light heavy, let's get it on at Matchroom. Like, any of them boys, anyone, do you know what I mean? Like, I just fought number four, where's Rocky Fielding at? Do you know what I mean? Them boys at super middle, let's fight. Look, I'll put on a show, and I'll fight anybody, do you know what I mean? So, let's do it. I've done 3 8-rounders this year against 3 guys highly ranked to me in the world and in the UK, and I've won 2 and drawn 1. Let's go all the way.
I think it's a formality that it's going to happen. It is, it really is.
These are the fights I get up for in the morning. These are why I get up early in the morning, go running. These are why I go to the gym every day. Like people say, oh, has it come too early? Mate, this is what I've been training for my whole life. I've had 200 fights as a kickboxer. It's nights like these, the way it all counts. And even when you ain't had a full camp and you can dig deep like that and perform and get stronger as the rounds go on, what does that say? I mean, it shows I belong here. Let's bring on the next fights. Look, I had 50 people come down on the week's notice, the your call.
51, and me.
Yeah, with you, Jack. All right, and come down and support me. I believe I was going to win. It was a great fight. Happy to get in the ring again with Craig Richards. He's a great guy. And wish him all the best in his next fight. I wish Shaq had the best, because end of the day, without us boxers, you lot don't get entertained. And people always think, oh, it's let's build up this rivalry. But look, we had no beef going into that fight. Best fight of the night. Do you know what I mean? No stalemate in there. We both went out to win. We both went out to hurt each other. Let's do it again.
Would you say that this would be, so far, I know you're still 25, but the highlight of your career?
Of course, man. I'm fighting it. You're called Bethnal Green, man. Like, all the legends fought. Reggie Craze fought there, do you know what I mean? Like, from the day, like, these boys, the people that fought there have all gone on to big things. Like, so it's my turn now to go on to big things. I'm 25. Let's do it again. Let's do it again. And let's do a fight. Look, let's fight a super middle. Let's do it again. It was great, great work.
It's been great speaking to you, Chad. I'm very pleased for you. Thanks for speaking to Jeff Boxing TV.
Thank you very much, Jack.